Hey everyone, hope y'all are doing well and staying safe out there. So I've got a really neat lock for you here today. This is a Corbin Emhart, Corbin Russwin Emhart. It was lent to me by my buddy David from District Locksport. So for those of you who don't know, this is a high security lock that has pins that need to be rotated. Kind of similar to the Medico. Unlike the Medico, though, this does not have a sidebar. What this does is it has a tongue and groove system on the key pins and driver pins that actually locks the pins together until you rotate them to the correct angle, which allows them to slide out and separate at shear. So it's definitely not an easy pick by any means. But it is fun, and hopefully I can get it open here for you so we can take it apart. I can show you how the thing works. So, anyway, let's get to picking and see what we can do here. So this keyway is pretty gnarly. Let's see. It's pretty hard to get a pick in there, so I'm just going to use the bottom of the keyway tensioner down here, since I can't really use that area anyway. And I actually had to use a specialty homemade pick for this thing because none of the other picks I had would bypass the warding and actually be able to set the pins. So, anyway, let's see what we can do here. There we go. All right, took a little longer than I wanted to, but that's okay. All right, let's go ahead and get this thing gutted. By the way, if you ever get into picking one of these, a lot of people think that they can't be reset from this point for the key to work again, but actually, all you gotta do is very gently rotate it back, let the drivers drop in, and then use the key, go to the side, and then set it, and the pins will then interlock again. So, alright. Let's get this thing gutted. That's good enough, I guess. Some C-clip pliers, it looks like. Oh, you know what? Let me do it from the top. I think I can do that. I think I checked and I'm pretty sure this top piece comes off. I hope I'm right. Maybe the other way. Don't want to damage the locks, not mine. Come on. Slide last time. I think I just got it to move a little bit. There it goes. Starting to, at least. That's tough. It's at least starting to go. Let's see if I can pull it the rest of the way off. Oops. Almost lost the spring there. There we go. All right. Got my tweezers and everything out. Okay. Mm-hmm. this the easy way. Just tip it. All right, so both of those pins should come out interlocked at the moment. Yep, there we go. Here's the one, so I'll get them all out of here and then I'll show you what they do. Six. All right, let's organize this stuff real quick. It came apart. All right, so look at the one here that came apart. That is what the driver pin looks like. It's got that little tongue there. And the key pin has a groove that the tongue slides into. So when they are connected, when they're in the lock, they actually are stuck together completely. So you can see there, that's what they look like when they're stuck together. So then they have to be rotated to the correct angle to be taken apart. Let me see if I can get this core out and I'll show you. There's a section on the core that actually I don't think that'll be too difficult. Famous last words. Should actually be able to just start it there. Damn, this is definitely made to use retaining ring pliers. Give me just a second. Hope I have the right tips on these. It does not look like it. Great. This is making my life difficult. Mm. hook it from the bottom there. Well, it's starting to work. There we go. All right, sorry that took so long. Okay, so there you go. So the core has these little ridges all around it. And that's actually why in the bottom of the key, you have those ridges there so it matches up with the core. Oops, wrong way. So then when your pins separate, your driver pin actually sticks down in that groove so you can turn the lock around. But yep, so that's about it. Unfortunately, these stopped being made quite a long time ago. This company got sued by Medeco for the whole rotating pin thing, and they had to stop making them. But, well, they actually had to pay Medeco every time they sold one, and they couldn't afford to keep going. But, unfortunate, because this is a really neat lock. But, anyway, there you are all, 6-pin Corbin Emhart. All right, take care, stay safe, be well.